What's up, YouTube? P-Town Piper here. Just got back from the second annual YouTube Pipe Presenters Conference, the Northwest. Second annual YouTube Pipe Presenters Conference. Just got back not too long ago. Had a great time. Yeah, some really good guys there. Got to meet some guys, you know, I've been watching their videos for a long time. And, it was cool to meet them. You know, I got to meet Scott, Sparky's Pipes, Metalhead Cigar Guy, Stephen W 140. He's cool. I really liked him. He's a really cool guy. I could already tell he was by his videos. You know, I've always liked him a lot. Stephen W, Sparky's Pipes is a really cool guy. Metalhead Cigar Guy is really cool. Met a couple other really cool guys there. One guy came, he's not from YouTube, he's from the Pipe Magazine forum, so, yeah, he was really cool. He hooked me up with a little bit of tobacco, so that was nice. I guess I'll show you what I got. I scored a little bit there. Metalhead Cigar Guy, I guess he had like some little prize packages, whatever, kind of made up, but, one of the guys that came, he brought his big bag of tobacco, but he forgot his pipes. So what happened was there was a pipe in the bag that I got, but he ended up giving it to the guy that forgot his pipes, obviously, because, you know, he didn't have a pipe, and, you know, the one that Metalhead Cigar Guy had was unsmoked, brand new, so, you know, of course, you know, he gave it to the guy. The guy needed a pipe to smoke, and I didn't care, you know, at all, really. Like, I didn't even think twice about it. I didn't care at all. It was a general corn cob. Which, I got plenty of corn cobs, I even have a general, too, so, I mean, I don't care at all, I didn't even think twice about it, but, the guy wanted to give me some tobacco, because he felt bad, because, you know, he thought that, you know, if he wouldn't have took the pipe, then, you know, I would have had it, so, you know, that was real nice of the guy. I mean, I didn't care whatsoever, but, he gave me a full jar of Lane 1Q, right here. Which I never had before today. Obviously, Scott Sparky's Pipes was there, and he let me try a bowl after I was first there, and I loved it. And then the guy that gave me this came later, and actually just giving it to me. He didn't even know that I had just tried it for the first time earlier and fell in love with it. So that was really cool. I got this cool poker from a Metalhead Cigar Guy. It's a piece of driftwood. With a 40 Smith & Wesson casing on the end. It's nice and smooth and, you know, glossy. It's got some polyurethane on there, so that's cool. Well made. I really like that. Got some good backies. This is from Tinderbox Tobacco. It's called Kelly's Blend. I did try a bowl while I was there. It was pretty good. I enjoyed it. Tinderbox Tobacco Natural Dutch Cavendish. I did not try this one yet. Looking forward to it, though. I like Cavendish. I noticed it's not black, so maybe that's the natural Dutch Cavendish instead of, like, black Cavendish or something. I'm not sure. This came with the pipe that I got from Metalhead, or the bag I got from Metalhead Cigar Guy. Some Tom & Jerry's cleaners for a pleasant smoke. Made in the USA. I like that. This also came in the package that I got from Metalhead Cigar Guy. These are obviously matches, and this is a little cube of beeswax, which I'm really happy I got that. I need some beeswax. I've been needing some for about a week or two now. Got a couple new pipes, and one of them's got a pretty loose stem, so I'm going to put some beeswax in there to tighten that stem up. Another backy I got from the cool guy from the Pipes Magazine forum. He was a real cool, real nice guy. Brought his son. You know, his son was pretty cool. He was, you know, younger, probably, I don't know, 8-9 years old, but, you know, he was cool. He went down and caught a crawfish barehanded and put it in like a 1 liter bottle of water and was carrying it around. You know, cool little kid. But I got some Music City tobacco. That's the brand name, Music City. The name is Sangria. Which, when I first smelled it, I thought that it was like an English kind, like it had a lot of Kia in it, but the guy told me it didn't. See, it still smells like a lot of Kia to me. He might have had it. like up against a different bag, because some of those Latakias will fucking leave that smell on everything. Oh, sorry for my English here. Sorry about that. I usually try not to cuss on my channel. But, you know, like some Peter Stokeby's Balkan Supreme, you know, like, you leave that in a drawer overnight, and you open up the drawer, and freaking, your whole room starts to smell like nasty Balkan, so nasty. Anyway, I had an ounce of Balkan Supreme, and I took there and gave away for free. I gave away some Balkan Supreme and some Sutliff Private Soft Blend number 5, because they're just like straight Latakia blends, and they're disgusting. I didn't like them at all. That's where I got the Sweet Killarney. That's why I got the bag from Metalhead Cigar Guy, because I gave him those tobaccos. I got this Sweet Killarney too. Tried a couple bowls of it. It's really good. It's got like a fruity smell to it, which it doesn't have any fruit added to it. It says it's a unique mixture of Virginia Burley, Maryland, and Black Cavendish, topped with a cream caramel flavor and blended with hand-rubbed Virginia flake. But to me, it's got kind of a fruity scent, almost like a orangey, tangy, plum kind of... I don't know, I'll be doing a review on this, you know, so I can tell you more about it, but, yeah. This is, some good stuff. Yeah, that's about it. Here's some, pulled pork that I made to take up there. And slow cooked that in the slow cooker for about 10 hours. That was, pretty good. Everyone pretty much liked it, so that was cool. Is that in the video? Well, might as well. You already saw it. It's my 9mm. Yes, I do have a permit to carry this. And yes, I do carry it everywhere I go. I do not leave the house without it. Right now I have it in an inside of the waistband holster. Sometimes I carry it in an outside of the waistband custom handmade Kydex holster that I actually make myself. Any of you out there firearms and you know what a custom Kydex holster is and you need one, let me know. I have a little shop set up where I make them. You know, I got all the belt sanders and, you know, everything you need to make a high quality custom Kydex holster. But anyway, that has absolutely nothing to do with what we're supposed to be talking about. Let's see what else here. Got my old BP gym, my Savinelli. Yeah, you've seen all my pipes. I think that's it, yeah. You know, other than the stuff I got, the conference went really well. It was at Hathaway Park in Washougal. I had a great time. Metalhead Cigar Guy, he wasn't disappointed, I would say, but, you know, I think he was really expecting some more people to be there, or, you know, kind of hoped more people would be there. But, I mean, for me, I mean, I had a really pleasant, good time. I mean, I didn't mind at all that there wasn't, you know, a lot more people there. It was really nice. You know, Stephen W140 is a real cool guy. You know, I really liked, you know, getting to meet him and Sparky's Pipes, obviously, and, you know, Metalhead Cigar Guy. I found out that Metalhead Cigar Guy actually frequents the tobacco store where I buy most of my stuff. So I kind of talked to him a little bit, and hopefully I'll be able to meet up with him, you know, some more. You know, go smoke some cigars at the shop or smoke some pipes, you know, just cool guy to hang out with and, you know, share pipes or share a cigar. Today actually was not the very first time that I, you know, smoked with somebody else, because I usually just smoke by myself. I don't know anybody else that smokes pipes or cigars. Besides one time, last Christmas, when I was up at the mountain, Mount Hood, and we rented a cabin, I got my dad to smoke a pipe a couple of times, so... wasn't my first time smoking with somebody else, but it was really like my third time in my entire life, and the other two times before that were like in the same day with the same person. So yeah, it was cool getting to smoke with a group of you know, cool guys and just have some, you know, good, cool, relaxed conversation and smoke some good baccy with some good pipes. So yeah, that's about it for the conference. You know, it went real well. Food was good, weather was great, park was cool. Yeah, it went really well. So, alright guys, that's it for this one. P-Town Piper, as always, peace.